design element 1B, this will be the module of this coursework, second one, out of the four in series, right? Third semester, fourth semester, fifth and sixth semester. So this is fourth semester where you are supposed to apply something that you have learned on the aspect of design thinking, right? So this specific module is dealing with the application part. So general perception is like, okay sir, we are doing the same thing, AEIOU we have done already, we made some team formation exercise, empathy we have done, mind mapping we have done, but here we are looking forward to have application part, we are exploring the application aspects, right? So doing that thing, this entire coursework is split over 14 weeks as of the length of the semester, and for the 14 weeks we have been made available with this course abstract, having week wise program, right? First week, second week, third week, fourth week, likewise up to 14th week. So most important things that I have highlighted that are something new compared to the semester 3, right? And even whatever you have done in semester 3 is expected to be repeated in this semester, but it will fetch something more, somewhat more insightful understanding about each and every aspect. Say for example, in the previous semester you have done, let us say, observation exercise by following AEIOU method. Somebody might have selected some intersection on a road, somebody might have selected some garden, somebody might have selected some construction site of a high rise building, maybe bridge site, maybe some foundation site. There are a lot of variety in terms of these sites and places which we may have gone for making observations. As such, there were no formats. This ethnographic tool was used, which gives enough degree of freedom to make our own sort of detailing. If I want to make certain drawings, I can do it. If I would give you a table, hello, this is the table, column 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These 10 columns restricted, you are supposed to place in all the records and observations into these tables. So it will not give you degree of freedom. You are, you know, bound by these constraints that this much and this type of observations I am supposed to take and I am not supposed to go beyond this. Right? So activities. So you have got some 4-5 boxes on the frame of activities. Similar one is to environment or objects or interaction. What basic thought about is like taking something which is normal as well as abnormal, unique, right? Something that we have anticipated before going to a site and what is being seen while we are on the site itself, right? So that is a difference which we need to make recorded for. Right? So something before going on site is called, you know, assumptions that okay, if I am going to a construction site, what I will be looking at, okay, observations, let us say talking about activities, okay, construction site is an activity, so some bar bending guys will be there bending up the, you know, steel bars, some guys will be cutting it off using some instruments, and some people would be making screening of sand, some people would be taking up bricks on certain floors where the brickwork is going on. All that sort of anticipation can be there because of our impressions of these sites and locations based on our experience. Okay, but when we go on the site in specific, there might be some additional events taking place simultaneously. So which are those? Right? So that sort of thing we have already done. Now here in semester 2, you have already done this AEIOU back again by changing over the topic, right? Or no?
Yes.
Yes, you have switched over the topic. Now that is very essential. Why? Because we are changing the working area. That means before I took an exercise for garden, now I want to take exercise on road. So the entire scenario changes. The context, location, everything changes. The people, user, everyone will be different than the earlier one, right? So similar one approach is required here in addition to these observations is called reverse engineering, or it also may be called as back engineering. So what is that? It is to be done for week 2 and 3. So about 6 hours of duration it is required to be performed for, right? Reverse engineering. So basic idea about this is to, you know, disassemble the existing selected artifact or product or component or process or system. We are supposed to disassemble it, okay? And to study technological aspects and design details thereof. So back engineering, see, at times when we are dealing with a computer program, say for example, you have some application loaded in your mobile phone, you get some program file for it, you might have some software installed in your computer, you want to play with the code of that, right? So you open it up. Now there might be some security features installed, but you crack that and extract the hardcore programming code out of it, you play with that code and modify this application. Now that is something called unethical operation. It is unethical operation, right? So reverse engineering term at times become unethical when it is disturbing the intellectual property of someone else without letting one know. If I am allowing you to disassemble, then it is okay. If not, then it is basically intruding into the intellectual property of someone, right? So that permission requires to be granted or fetched upon. Before that, if you are doing it, it is unethical operation. But for the part of our civil construction, things are like, you know, generalized in or more generalized in nature. Say for example, brickwork, if you want to analyze, things are open. Some furniture making, things are open. There are no privacy or there are no intellectual property involved. Say for example, assembly of this ceiling. I want to construct this ceiling. Okay, let me open this panel. Let me see and check what are the components. Let me see what is the wire there, what is the diameter of that wire, how many number of nails are, you know, plunged in the top of the ceiling, what are the components bound by which one, how they are bound, with what material they are bound. That sort of operations in civil engineering are there when it comes to a reverse engineering example. So there are no intellectual property rights infringement. It is all okay. You can open it and close it back again. If you want to see what is inside of this wall, we can always open this and close it back again, right? First of all, we'll remove the plaster and then we'll check out what is there inside, what is the strength and what is the other parameters, right? So there goes a number of complexities. I mean, whether I want to disturb it or not, that is the first aspect. If I want to see what is inside of this brick wall, I have got two options with me. Should I open it all? I mean, scrap off the plaster and break it off the brickwork and bonds and everything and see what is inside, or I should make an X-ray of it, or I find some other technique and tool so that I can have a cross-section of something that is inside. If there are some wires or bars, some electromagnetic fields are there, then there are automatic detectors available. If I want to play with or check with the strength aspect, there are non-destructive tests available, remount hammer and something like that. A lot of technology is available. Ultrasound sensors are available, right? So with that, using all these instruments and deploying all these techniques, we can find out somewhat more of insightful understanding about the components that are existing in the field of buildings and construction. Say for example, I want to understand the design aspects in a reverse engineering way for a traffic island, right? So traffic island, this is something I have already in place, so I need to go in reverse direction. What it must be done to put this particular component here? That question keeps on coming up. What it must be done, or whatever is done here, what could be the reason thereof? Right? So we keep on exploring each and every aspect as a part of reason for something that is available on the field, that is already executed on the field. Right? So going in reverse direction, because we are keeping the timeline in a reverse direction. What would be first done, and step by step we go at a stage where nothing was there. Okay, so what were the first step, second step, third step, fourth step? We go in a reverse manner. Okay, from the finished goods or finished process level thing, we go in a reverse direction to the point of having nothing at that particular time. Right? So step by step procedure will tell us more about what would be the requirements for carrying out this sort of something which I am examining. Right? So important things are here that each group has to select one branch specific component, product, artifact, program for reverse engineering activity for that DE-1B project and modify the same based on extracted information as per user's need. Very important, and it is asking you to understand these insightful engineering aspects involved. Number two part is modify the same based on extracted information as per user's need. So who are the users? We need to identify their requirements. Because of certain requirements, they are using this facility or the component which is constructed, say for example a staircase, what are their requirements and what are the missing pieces or pieces of difficulty that needs to be resolved as per the perception of these users. So what modifications can be done or we can do in a group to make this staircase or the intersection of road in an improvement manner, right? So that needs to be done as a part of reverse engineering. Now there are some steps given here. Number one is to select branch specific artifact or component, which you have already done because you have done the AEIO observations rounds, and I am hoping that you are done with your summary of this AEIO, clubbing up with all five individual sets. If not, you can do it. Number two is disassemble it for learning the technical or engineering aspects involved in it. So what are the technical aspects, what are the engineering aspects? That we need to make an identification. If material is involved, what kind of material, what is the size and shape, what is the strength. If it is steel, check it out with the steel table. You are aware of steel table? Radius of gyration and moment of inertia and IXX and IYY, density, all this sort of information is readily available in the steel table, right? So that sort of things need to be explored. If it is wood, what is the property of that wood, whether it is weathered or not, whether it is made termite proof or not, right? Whether it is its surface is finished. If it is finished, what are the layers or probable layers that would be made to make it user friendly. Otherwise rough wood will be a bit dangerous for the use when human hand or human body surface is in contact, right? So what are those processes we need to extract and understand? And for that, very importantly, we are not understanding and knowing everything. So we need to take interviews of people who are involved in this activity, right? So for interviewing, we need to employ certain techniques. We may go for formal interview, we may go for informal interview, right? If I am talking to, let us say, you, that you are involved in something which I am interested to understand. So I will come to you, sit with you and ask, how you are doing this thing, let me see if you are doing it right then. Otherwise I will ask, what is the process, what are the steps, what are the points that you take care for doing this particular thing. I will understand the entire process. I may go and take a videography if something, some process is carried out, right? So watching this video again and again and again, it will help me understanding and giving me more of insight that at which process what sort of things are taken care of, because everything that is getting done while making a production, it has got some specific order of doing things, right? If there is say some wood cutter and I am placing my wood belly into it, right? I need to place it in a particular angle. I must push it with certain speed and force, right? Otherwise, thing will not work. So what is that? How much is that? That sort of thing needs to be scratched up, right? Everything needs to be very specific when something process point of view is required to be understood. Say for example, plaster on a wall. So when I am doing a plastering activity on a wall surface, it's a different aspect. If I am doing the same plastering on the ceiling, it is a different pathology. So what are the differences? What are the steps to be followed? That sort of thing I need to understand when I am exploring this plastering activity in a reverse manner. Otherwise and until then, I will not be able to disassemble this entire wall because my wiring is concealed. Electrical wiring is concealed. I only can see is a switchboard on a wall. So what must it be having inside, I mean below the plaster, beneath the plaster. And when I am doing this wiring work embedded in the wall, what is the process that must be followed? Whether it is going to affect my wall strength or not, that needs to be checked. For non-affection on the strength aspect, what are the measures to be taken? That needs to be talked about. Right? At the end, I must also get the finishing level very much smooth and fine along with the other part of the wall. It must not be making some hump on the wall. Right? So that sort of things need to be understood. So the thing is like to disassemble and then apply design thinking approach to find out the unmet needs of user related to selected artifact or component. Then fourth step is to follow phases of observation, empathy, ideation and product development by preparing related canvases and framework. Right? So whatever you have done so far in AEIU framework, for reverse engineering exercise, we need to make all this sort of canvases as a part of reverse engineering. Okay? So AEIU in general, observations in general, empathy in general, at your themed area is a one part. For reverse engineering, we are doing entire exercise but with a different perspective again. Okay, so there will be two sets of all these sort of documents. And then fifth step is to modify or redesign the artifact or component to meet users' unmet needs. We need to make a proposal on modification based on reverse engineering. Okay, these are the major findings. These are the difficulties that people are facing right now while they are doing and involved in this particular operations, and this could be a probable suggestion to make it improvised. Right? So that sort of end point result is to be obtained. And then after reverse engineering study with extracted information from branch specific artifact component, students team need to apply design thinking approach learned in third semester. All phases of third semester D1A would be repeating here to modify or redesign that selected artifact component based on users unmet needs. Here one need to make all canvases and framework again as topic different than third semester, right? So all these sort of canvases will be done twice. Okay, all these canvases will be done twice by each of you. Now what is that which is making it different than the regular exercise, right? So let us take an example. If we visualize the construction of a road, any topic, what is your topic, Idris? What are you making observations for?
We make a
highway.
Highway?
Highway, where? Some area, outside Surat. Okay, please be seated. Okay, so he has taken up the highway as a project. And by this highway, what I can understand is, are you going to propose some alignment that will tell me connection from two specific points of interaction? right? If I am working on the alignment aspect, it is going to fall under traffic planning. So I need to understand the insightful, background related to traffic planning aspect, right? For plan to plan out some connectivity between two points where it is not existing, I need to make some sort of study. Say for example, origin and destination service. How many people are going from one place to the other place? At what frequency? For what purpose? At what duration? Right? All that sort of information needs to be sought. And for that, mostly this household survey is being carried out. OD survey will be making OD matrix. It is like origins on here and destinations on here. This place, how many people, likewise, which is the important points of interest. And then accordingly we give a alignment of the road. This is one part if I talk about highway. Okay. If I am going to make construction of this highway, construction of a highway will tell me, rather ask me, what is the width of the road required. So here only, as soon as we have this OD matrix with us, we have got certain number of vehicles passing from one point to another point. We have got vehicular information which tells us the PCU, passenger car unit, PCU per hour per direction. Okay, from this point to this point, this many number of PCU. PCU is passenger car unit. One car, which is a simple car, let's say for example, Nissan Micra or Maruti Frontier, or maybe Ambassador, which is obsolete these days. But that sort of car which is carrying 5 persons, which has got specific dimensions, 2.4 meter wide, 3.6 meter in length, with a height of about 1.8 meters. This standardized specification. Now that vehicular information is made available to Indian Road Congress. What is the standard size of a car? How much space it requires for going through on a road? What should be the clear cover on either side? And top, front and bottom, rear side to make it a safe transition on road, right? So 2.6 meters plus some space will give me lane width. A lane width is recommended as 3.5 meters minimum for a single direction movement of a vehicle. Okay, so as soon as I have got some number in terms of PCU, that will tell me the requirement. Okay, this many number of cars are traveling from this road, maximum number of traveling vehicles is this much, and accordingly, based on IR's recommendation, this much wide road, either divided or undivided, will be required. Okay, so that part, as soon as I have this width, let us say 12 meter road, into two sides with one median will tell me 25 meters wide road. Total width of my road is 25 meters. This much is done as far as the planning aspect is concerned. As soon as I have got this width with me, I have got alignment laid, I will go for construction aspect. So construction will require me to what is the FL, what is the formation level. Formation level is the top of the road. You must have carried out example in the surveying one, the datum, cutting and filling, some Simpson rule or trapezoidal formula must be used for extracting the earth cut, right? Similarly, you must have learned about the curve establishment, establishing a curve on a road, on the horizon, right or not? So all those things are employed when the alignment is worked out. As soon as we have got this road width with us, let us say 25 meter road, wide road is to be constructed, we derive upon a specific cross section. Cross section of the road, this is my carriageway, this is another carriageway. What are the road components? Now, when I talk about the construction, this is my FL, this is my FL, and I want to go inside. What will be my different layer sizes? How much of what layer? What will be different depths? Now, for those depths, I will need to have information about the underlying ground surface. So, I will need to understand what is the soil characteristics. At a particular line, the center line, over which I am going to lay down my entire of this road stretch. So what are the strength already there on the surface of the earth? Let me understand that. So IFC recommends that every 100 meters there should be collected one undisturbed sample of soil, and that soil sample needs to be tested in labs to identify various parameters. So what I need is to understand this particular information, whether it is available from some road which is already existing on the field. If yes, then I must fetch the report and I must go through the entire of this report to understand what was the existing parameters of soil strength, soil particles and all these relevant aspects that are covered in the soil testing report. Right? That based on the soil testing report, I will be able to make what would be the depth of my subbase, what will be the depth of my base layer, and what will be the depth of my finishing layer. Depending on the strength parameters of the underlying ground, this depth will be varied. The material in this depth will be varied. Many times this base is constructed 300 mm, 600 mm, 1 meters, 1000 mm, using 150 mm, 200 mm size of boulders. Large size boulders, they are just dumped. And then a roller is making a compaction. Then again different grade of this material is placed in, so that the voids are filled. It becomes a dense mass. Right? And then compaction is done. Later on, a stage of consolidation is also observed. Right? So when I am talking about reverse engineering, one aspect is this alignment, which falls into the traffic planning aspect. Here you can explore a DPR, detailed project report of any existing road. We will get all the survey results and findings therein with a justification for proposal connecting two places with a specific width of the road, along with this proposed cross section. Okay, here whether I need a cycle track or not, whether I need some spacing for pedestrian or not, what will be my side drain, whether I need it a stone drain at the corner along with the road or not. All that sort of things are justified. Redford data is also taken care and considered. Right? What will be the longitudinal slope of the entire terrain? How many number of structures are there? I mean natural features are there. Let us say for example, if we are talking about highway, there will be rivers passing through. There will be some canals passing through. There will be some railway line. There will be some electricity line, gas pipelines, right? All that sort of infrastructure might be there in the place. There might be some swampland, marshy land. All that sort of features can be there, right, within my alignment. So I need to take care of all these aspects. So that goes with the cross drainage works, CDW, cross drainage works. So how many number of culverts I am supposed to construct to cross over these facilities, right? Because if there is a canal, I cannot make a simply through from the canal, making my highway passing through this canal. I must make a culvert, ne? May it be a box culvert or pipe culvert or whatever type I can select later on, but there must be one culvert. Right? Similarly, a railway line is crossing the highway alignment. There should be a culvert, or there may be some flyover bridge, right? Grade separation. There may be on-road crossing with gates or without gates, depending on the PCU, traffic volume, that I am observing. So all that sort of things can be understood from a report called detailed project report for so and so bridge. Now from where to obtain this? You need to visit some roads and building department's office. If it is highway, better to visit with unit of National Highway Authorities of India. If it is about urban road, maybe Surat Municipal Corporation be approached. Say for example, this Gauravpath recently constructed in Arajan, Pali. Right? You have gone up there? Gauravpath?
Yes.
Right? So there must be some report, some sort of planning attempted. Right? Similarly, this Gauravpath was there from Sargam to Dumas. There also they prepared a lot of drawings and made lot of studies with which we can get the data in form of detailed project report. But when it comes to about its formation, this is transportation engineering design of pavement. Right? So pavement design related codes will be applicable. Pavement design. So IRC has got another aspect, number of codes regarding this pavement. Here also we will have to club it up with IS codes. IS code for testing the soil. You might have gone through a few of the IS code numbers while performing GP1 lab. Right? This is the code which tells us about the classification of soil, different parameters of strength related to this. Number of codes are there. Right? Other materials, say for example boulders. So if I am getting basalt boulder of 150 mm size, what would be the strength of it? What kind of sample I must use and which I should discard and not use? Quality matters. If it has got white, you know, dots on the surface, that means it has got impurities. The basalt has got impurities and it must be checked before I am using it for certain specific operation. Otherwise, if it is satisfying the strength aspect, it is okay. Otherwise, we must not use this and replace the entire material, right? So, quality aspects will be there into the picture. Then comes the workmanship aspect, right? Workmanship is altogether another another aspect to be explored in connection with the IS course. How to carry out certain operation? What are the steps? What are the procedures that are called standard procedures and set of procedures? If we are not following this procedure, we are moving ahead with, you know, loss of a quality of investment that we are performing. Because if the steps are not followed the way it should be, then we are playing with the quality aspect. Although we have got use of very fine and good quality of material, but at the end, the composite product made up of number of materials will not give us the desired result. Right? It happens when we talk about concrete. We design concrete for M30 grade, but if the design mix is not done properly, it may give us poor result. If the design mix is proper, but the concrete laying is not proper, it may not give us good result. If the laying is proper, vibration and curing is not proper, it may give us poor result. So there needs to be checkpoints at number of occasions, starting from material till the end of finished of these products. So all these stages are comprising of number of checkpoints. These checkpoints we need to explore in form of reverse engineering. But to begin with, a word, let us say highway, in which dimension we are exploring. So what are the points in the background that needs to be explored? And if it is about building construction, this floor that we are seeing is a finished floor. This floor is a finished floor. Okay, let us make an exercise. What could be the component that needs to be checked? So what I am going to ask you all is to identify different steps in an reverse order. This is a finished floor.
finished flooring surface. Where? That you need to be specific. In this classroom, okay, C301. In C301 room. Okay. So what is the type of this floor?
Tiles.
Type needs to be identified. So what are different types of floors available? Flooring tiles are available in market. That was your number question 1. Understood? Then if this type I have identified, okay, this is the type. What is the size? Question number 2. If this is the size, what is the surface? Surface finishing. Very smooth and fine. But it has got alternatives. Right? What is the strength? Strength in terms of abrasion. Abrasion means what? What is abrasion property? It gives us toughness. Toughness is the resistance against what?
Scratches.
Right? So we always keep on walking around like this. People, you know, dragging these benches from here to there. Number of people use this classroom as dancing floors. A lot of things keep on happening around, right? So the flooring must not get disturbed. That is the prima facie concern, right? When we are repositioning these benches and furniture in the flooring on the floor, the tile floor must be remaining as it is. It must not be having, you know, scratched off. A lot of it scratches. It is okay after 20 years. It is okay after 20 years of usage. There might be some scratches here and there. That's a different part. But at least for 20 years, 15 years of its initial life, it must not bear these scratches on the surface, right? So it must look good. Okay. So that strength in terms of abrasion, it must be thumping around. So it must have some compressing capacity. Right? So we need to identify all these involved aspects in terms of strength. Now these aspects will be available readily as soon as we identify this particular material in terms of type, size and surface. The company provides all these details because these products are IS specified. Indian standard specified. So number of tests are already performed on the number of samples in that too in a specific manner, how to do testing work. Okay, these things are already defined. So all we need to understand is to get a summary of all these aspects from the manufacturer or the reseller. Maybe we want to have all this information, please provide us for this specific type. Okay, number one part is done as far as this what we are looking at the surface. Number two is I have got it connected. So that part goes with the joints. Joints, right? So what material I have used for joining two tiles? Is it white cement? Is it putty? Is it something else? Okay, so that sort of information needs to be acquired. Here we have got two tiles clubbed together. At places you will find there is some space of 2.5 mm, 5 mm. Now how that space at the junctions and ends of each tile must be maintained. So people, the layman, the workman, people must have used some spacer bar. It's a plastic spacer available of this sort, which has got specific size. Say for example, this is 5 mm. So each side is 5 mm. Each side is 5 mm. So as soon as my one tile is laid, another tile is laid, I will put a spacer here, go for another tile and another tile. So I will get uniformly 5 mm space all around all the tiles. A groove of uniform size will be created while I am laying off the tiles, and in this groove I may go for colored cement, I may go with some putty, I may go with some cementitious chemical, depending on the particular type of use that I am going to employ for this flooring, right? So it may also a requirement for some beautification point of this joint looks wonderful. If these tiles are to be placed on a wall, I will do it with this joint, the spacer joint. Right? If I am going with flooring, if my tile is of a kind, I may go for some spacer joints. As soon as this information is extracted at the joint part, then I will go for what would be the bedding. So what materials I must have used? I must have used cement plus sand plus water, wetting it all, cement, water. What is the depth? What is the proportion? What is the time for laying? All this sort of information we need to extract. Beyond this depth, let us say it's 25 mm depth. So 25 mm depth is my cross section like this. This is my tile surface. Then 25 mm of this cement mortar. This is 25 mm. Is there any sand bed of some 50 mm or not? And then my RCC floor is there. So I need to understand what is the cross section. Why these different type of elements are there? Whether the sand is made available? It usually is made available when we are laying of the tiles in outside of the building. Here we have PCC in general. If it is not room, we have PCC. And above this PCC, we lay down sand layer, dry sand. Once this sand layer is done, we go for cement mortar and then we place potassium or something like that in the compound area. If it is inside of the room, we do not provide the sander because the RCC slab has got certain clean and uniform surface available, leveled surface. Right? PCC might not have been attempted with so much good quality of surface finish, but here we can have good level of surface finish because it's a on-field casting situ slab of RCC. Right? It's a structural element. So we need to make inquiry about this sort of cross section. We need to understand all these properties related to CM. At the end, this bedding material, what are the strength aspect, that also we need to check. And strength aspect will depend on, again, all these materials that are employed. It will bring down us to IS requirements for each of the material, and the strength aspect will tell us, IS requirements will be telling us about the strength aspects, the workability aspect, the consistency aspect, all that sort of things will be popping up as soon as we are making inquiry in a reverse manner. So we are going in a direction from finished surface to the surface where no flooring was there. Are you understanding? And by the time we are coming up from so many things which were possibly unknown to us. What were the IS requirements? What were the IRC requirements? What were the standard set of procedure? What were the material strength and other aspects? Were we knowing about all this? As soon as we started talking about this finished flooring? No. Were we knowing all the different types and size and surface available in the market with their certain properties? No. So this will tell you and us about the more of insightfulness of something that we are exploring in terms of technical aspects, in terms of marketing aspect. We may include here a comparison of costs. What flooring is available at what price? Because labor will be almost similar. The cost of material, as soon as there is a variation in the cost of material, there will be variation in the finished product. Because the laying process, the bedding process is remaining the same. Nowadays, options are available where we do not need this bedding at all. Simply paste certain chemical on the back side of the tire, paste it on the RCC floor, and we are done. That sort of things are also available. So what are the alternative uses? That also can be explored. Right? So that way, we keep on exploring these existing components in a reverse manner that tells us more of insightful understanding about execution aspect, the design aspect. At the same time, when this execution is going on somewhere and if we are going for making an observation, as such, I was reading through that all these canvases has to be reposed. So we must visit a site where flooring is ongoing. You must visit a site where highway is being constructed. Right? So the people will be there in the picture, the machinery will be there in the picture. A lot of activities will be going on simultaneously. So we need to make an observation canvases for that. We need to make empathy over certain user. Right? Because it all will tell us and get us connected with these reverse engineering aspects, apart and separate from the work which we were doing in a regular manner. Are you getting the point? At the end, we also need to perform ideation and product development canvas for which this existing methodology, existing materials can be improvised. That will close the part of reverse engineering. Okay? Any questions here? Will you be able to carry out? What are your topic?
Soil.
Soil, what in soil? Something. What kind of soil? You want to improve the strength of soil?
Yes.
Or if you want to improve the drainage property of soil?
Improve the strength of soil. By removing some
impurities.
By removing some debt because of impure soil.
Impurities in soil. Okay. Now see, soil is a natural property. You want to improve this strength of soil where? On particular location? Or the soil which is being carried in your construction site? Where?
On particular
field. In general. Let us say some space constructed as a garden or some road space or maybe some waterfront, riverfront. Which sort of?
It's a particular construction site.
Because, see, there are different aspects we need to understand. If it is a natural soil, of course the soils are natural material, right? We are not able to produce it in the lab. When the soil is natural, what kind of use I am going to put it for? Whether I am going to simple compact it and start overlaying different layers above it, selected soil, maybe some sand, maybe some other layer, and start using that particular part as a road, one aspect. Right? Am I going to excavate this soil, take it to some other site, I am going to use it as a filler material for some other purpose? It's a different aspect. What kind of thing we are taking forward for that particular soil? It will tell us what to make inquiry for. And for that we need to first identify that what kind of existing project, existing product, existing process which already has been done for the type of thing that I am thinking of. Right? Say for example, to make more stability and to achieve more strength in soil for a road, lime has been used for construction of road. Later on, some experiments were done with fly ash, bagasses, maybe some slag of metals, right? A lot of things have been done so far. So, what are those things already done? Let us understand that first. how these processes are done in a lab, on a field. What are different aspects that needs to be taken care of? See, right now we are in second year. So don't get, confused. Don't worry about it. Just try to be, natural to understand all this process. How these things are carried out. We are not supposed to mesmerize and remember all these IS code provisions. Forget. No. We are not supposed to. At least get to know about what IS codes are applicable, what kind of provisions it is giving. That is fine. Samajh pade the? Everyone is following. Right? At least be aware about different provisions of standard documents, standard procedures. What are the strength of materials? What kind of tests are to be performed? What are the procedures for execution of these particular things while we are doing the operations on field, in the lab? Right? Keep making a summary of that. This is something that I have learned, this is something that I came to know, this is something that I made aware of. All that sort of. This is what your reverse engineering is all about. We are making notes of something that we were not knowing. At the same time, we are also exploring the things in a reverse direction, from a finished good to good in separate parts. Because everything that is in front of us is a finished good, was once a different type of raw material. So what were the raw materials? How and why they were all combined? What were the parameters because of which they were combined? Right? Because when we are asking this sort of question, at each and every stage, we have got lot of alternatives in front of us. Here also, as I said, that chemicals are available, which can omit this bedding aspect. That is one alternative. Okay? Here we have got mortar, cement and sand. What kind of sand? What kind of sand? Is it white sand or black sand? What is the particle size diameter? Which sieve is passing through and retained for? Right? Now this sieve analysis result will tell us the strength aspect. It will get connected with the workability. It will get connected with the cost. It will get connected with the volume. Kya lage? Everybody is following. The cement also. If I am using 35 grade, 55 grade, what kind of grade of cement I am using? Do I have any alternative with cement? I don't want to use cement. What other materials I can use? Can I go with lime? Can I go with pozzolana cement? Low heat cement? Do I need some strength as a prime aspect? Do I want to get this floor finish available by next 24 hours? No, 5 days, 7 days, 10 days. I am not in any hurry to use this floor. Okay, so I will go for some pozzolana cement, low heat cement, which will reduce my cost also. Are you understanding that aspect? Right, so we have got lot of alternatives. The water, what kind of water I am using? Filter water, the water available by municipal corporation. Am I using RO plant water? What kind of water? Alternatives are available in water quality also these days. Right? So, depending on those availability in options available, alternatives, the cost will be different. The workforce requirement will be different. And we get to know about different components as soon as we explore these aspects in a reverse manner. What it must have been done to get this thing here. Or in front of us as a finished good, because we always have been confront in form of something that has been finished well. This table, for example, right? This table is, I am using it, the benches, you people are using it, but what is the length of welding at a particular joint? What is the size of this square bar, rectangle bar? What is the size? At what distance there is some horizontal member? Right? What is the thickness of the ply? What is the width? What is the length? What is the support arrangement? All that sort of things will come up front as soon as we start exploring. And at the end, we will go to a consensus that this is all because the size of a human. Okay, size of a human, Idris has got different height. Right? What is the name?
Dennis
has got different height. What is the name?
Deep
has got different height.
Nancy
has got different height. What are your height? Please stand up, all four. Okay. These three are almost equal. Are you people feeling comfortable on sitting on the back? No. You? Yes. Yes or no? Yes. You are comfortable. You are? It's okay. Not so very much.
Not very much.
Okay. What about you, Bhai? You. What is the name?
Ravi.
You comfortable? You can sit for the whole day. Say for example 5 hours, no problem, with of course some breaks. Okay. So please, what is your height?
5 feet 8 inches.
184 centimeters. That is about 5'11". What is your height? 5 feet 8 inches. So please be seated. Here, 5 feet 2 inches, 5 feet 8 inches. Two guys are telling us that they are comfortable sitting on the bench. But as soon as I enter into the length of a human, that is beyond 5 feet 10 inches. Anybody with 5 feet 10 inches? 5'10", not 6'10". 5'10". Right? So this is a determining parameter that up to what length of a human this bench will serve and release the level of comfort of sitting. Otherwise what will happen, the person having larger length will have to make more bending of the ankles, and continuous bending of the ankle will generate difficulty in sitting. So what can be done? As a part of modification, can I make a bench with some minimal adjustments that will allow me for height adjustment? If the answer is yes, it should be done. What requires to be done? That was the question. As soon as we have this question in front of us, another product is taking up birth, you see. A new product is coming up. Necessity. This invention, mother of all inventions, necessity, right? So we have got different alternatives available for sitting at lot of places in a throughout a day. But if we are supposed to stay here only, this only bench is there where I am supposed to sit all the time, I'll make necessary adjustments for myself for sure. Will I not or no? I will do that. Customization. Right, so that customization converted in a newer product, if I am taking a start with a line of products of that specific as a marketable product, it's a new business, a new product in the market, right? So that way, as soon as we are making inquiries of different type, things can be coming up, a newer concept, newer thing, because we are exploring what is the difficulty aspect here. I am not comfortable. Comfort is one of the difficulties, if not available. I am not feeling good, discomfortable. What are the other affecting aspects? See, the fan is not working here, number one. There is no movement of winds, number two. There is some heat, number three. Despite you have got long, sleeve t-shirt with worn this t-shirt. That is number four. Still you are not feeling comfortable because of bench. Is it the sole reason, or all this is an effect of, mixed effect of all these aspects? That application needs to be done very carefully. Right? If we are able to make that sort of separation while we are exploring the reasons that why something is like this, then only we can work out for some improvement in the design. Okay? Any other questions? Thank you.